back here with Sarah Bookalus, local democracy reporter. We're going to get our teeth stuck into planning issues, one of my favourite, and love a good old planning committee. And it got a bit fruity, didn't it? A bit spicy on some of the issues.
Yeah, the Goldstone Retail Park cost a coffee. Yeah. Oh, my goodness. There were some great comments in that one. One of my favourites, I ended my own story with, where Daniel Yates sort of seemed to be referring to licensing panels, where he said we must protect young people from bad coffee. He wasn't talking about Costa, but other potential outlets in the Goldstone Retail Park. Other coffee shops are available in the Hove Park area. I personally enjoy the Hove Park Cafe, and I've also been to the little place in the parade, which I think it's called Monda near Sackville Road.
Yeah,
very nice. Anyway, lots of places in Hove to have coffee, and Costa want to stick a branch, or they have permission now to stick a very small little branch in a little patch of the car park between TK Maxx and Nando's. I didn't even know that patch of car park existed. I don't think it's even registered.
Yeah,
it's
just, I know exactly where they meet. It's a little corner there as well.
Yeah, so just and the people that live in the road next to it, they're very concerned about the noise and everything. And the original planning application had it as 24 hours, but Costa said no, we're not doing that. You know, I think it's good. They did sort out the time, 7 o'clock in the morning to 10 o'clock at night, because they know what they're going to be serving is not people heading there as a coffee destination, as they may do for other coffee shops, but they're actually going to be serving the customers of TK Maxx, Lidl, Pets at Home, the place that sells sofas there.
Yeah.
You know, it's not a destination. And there was some discussion about the Pavilion Retail Park's Costa Coffee, because that's quite an attractive building next to Aldi on Lewis Road. And again, that doesn't actually attract destination coffee people. That is serving your Aldi, Bobby Craft and B&Q customer. So that's all good. But one of the things, Hove Park Ward Councillor Samir Begin, who is a professor of planning, he raised the issue of putting beauty into the heart of the planning system. And he wanted councillors to refuse it because there is a national policy to build in beautiful places.
True.
And he described it as a hideous grey shed.
Yeah.
Now that, of course, anyone who watches council meetings will know that was like a red rag to a bull to people like Tony Janio and Daniel Yates, because Tony Janio said the retail park was hardly the Taj Mahal. And then Daniel Yates questioned which buildings were the benchmark of beauty, which, yes, Goldstone Retail Park. It is a series of grey sheds. It might be nice to have something pretty in the corner, but a grey shed it will be, not the sort of brick-built style that we have in the Pavilion Retail Park.
Yeah.
There was also a lot of concern about parking. There has been an official analysis done by Lidl before they moved in there, and they found that even at the busiest time, there were about 23 places in the car park. I find that quite strange, because it's often quite difficult to park in there if I'm going that way, and I generally avoid it. But apparently so. It is about 23 places. And Claire Moonan, she was like, really? I go in there. It's always a bit tight. But the general idea that it's not going to be a coffee destination probably swung the balance, that it's not going to cause too many problems.